Hey, today I'm going to show you how to use AI to clean up any text, formatting, messy data in Google Sheets. Hey, let's jump in and see how to get started with Prompt Loop in 60 seconds. This is a tool that lets you use AI models in Google Sheets with a simple formula. The first thing we have to do is find and install the Sheets add-on. When you open a new sheet in your Google account, you'll see extensions on the top of the toolbar, and then add-ons as the first option. Click Get Add-ons, and then we can search. We'll see it as the top result. Click and install. That's it. We're all set. No need to set up an account. We're ready to go. So next thing I'll see is in our extension bar, we now have a menu item. The way Prompt Loop works is we take a set of input and output examples that tell the model what you want to do. In this example, we have a bunch of fruits, and on the right, we have colors. The model can pick up exactly what we want to do. So I'll start typing just like I would with any formula, and you'll see it pop up here. We can click that or hit tab to start the formula. First, we'll select this range, making sure it matches the output range, and we'll make this an absolute reference. I can talk about this later, but basically you can hit F4 and it'll always focus on these cells. We'll then add a comma, select our output range, F4 again, another comma, and now here, we're selecting our target, what we want to calculate on every time it runs. So this raisin is our target, and we're going to hit enter. We'll see it load, and then it's going to tell the color. We're going to drag down and give us an accurate picture of what fruits and colors are. This is a basic example, but we'll move on to more complicated examples next. So same input and output syntax. We can look at something more generative, like coming up with snappy, short product headlines for a Shopify or Amazon listing. With two examples, with features on the left and outputs on the right, we can use Prompt Loop with just two examples to take a look at the inputs, the target, and then give us a calculation for the outputs. So these lovers are a perfect accessory for afternoons with the family. That sounds nice. Again, just a starting point, maybe a draft. Maybe you have 1,000 listings before you tweak them and add in your special touch. Again, you can use these examples or your own, so it's going to come out in exactly the voice and tone you start with. Jumping one step further, sentiment analysis, categorizing, and understanding text is really important for a lot of use cases. So in this example, we have customer survey feedback points. These customers left our product, so we can use it to understand why they left, what we might want to improve, and whether or not they might be someone we could win back. I went ahead and added in examples here, but you likely have a starting point to base your model off of. Start with prompt loop, select examples, then select our output examples, and then our target. And we can drop this down and return the answer, whether it's a category, a sentiment, or text extraction.